I hate rom-coms. They're full of the same tired tropes. For example, when sperm meets an egg, there's a literal spark. I'm so over it. Hello, everyone. I'm Crystal here for D News. Recently, researchers from Northwestern University reported the discovery of a zinc spark in human oocytes. This phenomenon, known to occur in other mammalian species, is the result of sudden releases of zinc after egg fertilization. Before mammalian eggs or oocytes are either released by the ovaries or harvested by a doctor, they absorb billions of zinc atoms that act as a signal for them to halt meiosis cell division and wait to be fertilized. They're in a holding pattern until they meet a sperm. And if they do meet one, at that moment of fertilization, several things have to happen all at once. First, the egg has to protect itself from the insertion of DNA from multiple sperm, which it does by using sodium ions to set an electric fence around the cell. Then it releases calcium to, among other things, harden the outer vitellin membrane surrounding the egg and make it impenetrable to other sperm. Once it's protected itself, it needs to rev up its metabolism and start dividing, but it can only do that by releasing all of its zinc ions in a series of strong bursts. Scientists call these sparks. Zinc sparks have been observed in a bunch of other mammals, but until this study, we weren't sure whether it occurred in humans. To determine whether we do it too, scientists bathed human oocytes in a petri dish of fluorescent dye that can only emit light when zinc is present. At the beginning of the experiment, all the zinc was inside the cell, so they saw no signal. But then they injected an RNA construct into the oocytes to emulate fertilization, and it worked. They observed a burst of light from around some eggs, indicating their zinc had been released. To be clear, scientists didn't want to make actual humans in the lab, and they didn't actually fertilize the eggs with human sperm. Instead, they used a synthetic blank RNA construct common in this type of experiment. From the study results, the scientists were able to conclude that human eggs, like those of mice and non-human primates, do exhibit the zinc spark, which is cool. And the zinc signal can be used as an indication of health and embryonic progression after fertilization. This is even cooler. If the technique were to migrate from the lab to the doctor's office, it could have a significant impact on in vitro fertilization, or IVF, because that spark is proof that progression into an embryo has begun. Well, you will probably never see these zinc sparks. They're happening every time a sperm successfully fertilizes an egg. This spark of life can tell researchers and IVF doctors which eggs are good. This is helpful because IVF normally involves artificially bringing together harvested eggs and sperm from potential parents. After they meet, the zygotes are implanted into the woman's womb. Then everyone crosses their fingers, and they often implant more than one to increase the odds of success. Even still, the CDC reports women under 35 have the best chance for IVF success, but that rate is only around 40%. The ability to visualize these newly discovered zinc bursts at the time of fertilization could guide selection of healthy, successfully fertilized eggs for implantation, improving pregnancy success rates, reducing the need for repeat procedures, lowering costs, and easing the long, expensive, and emotionally draining process for potential parents. Go science! Embryonic cells can be used for a ton of amazing things. Learn more about how we can grab stem cells guilt-free in Julian's video here.
What makes embryonic stem cells amazing is that they are pluripotent, meaning they can become almost any type of cell. This means they can be used to replace damaged tissue and may one day be an alternative to organ transplants.
Are there any other human processes you want to know about? I'd love to dig into them. Let me know in the comments and be sure to subscribe to D News so you can see the answer.